3D sport, the spirit of India.
Pullela Gopichand, a man with never-dying spirit inside, with steely resilience. He is a person who has badminton in every breath that he takes. A person for whom these lines are the most apt. Khudi ko kar buland itna, khudi ko kar buland itna, ke har takdeer se pehle, khuda bande se khud poochhe, bata, teri raza kya hai. A person who made the mountains move to achieve the greatest of the heights in the game of badminton is Pullela Gopichand.
For me, for my career, I think the All England win was very important.
You know, right from the beginning, we had the, he had the ability, we had the confidence that he could do it.
In fact, the All England championships, he was the best smasher in the entire tournament.
When he went for that All England, I was thinking in my personal capacity that probably he is capable of going up to the quarterfinals at least.
Especially speaking of the All England, because I was there when he won it, his physical fitness, his physique, the form that he was in was just magical.
He was hitting down the line powerful smashes which I have never seen him.
I don't think there was anybody even in India that thought at that moment that Gopi would win the All England championship.
Pullela Gopichand was the second Indian to win the All England championship in 2001 after legendary Prakash Padukone. To connoisseurs of badminton, the All England Championship is a jewel in the crown. Pullela Gopichand's grit saw him carve a niche for himself in the nation's pantheon of all-time badminton greats. It was in 2001, Gopichand took his steady strides to shuttling glory as the badminton world watched.
As a youngster, he had all the ingredients which are required to be a champion, physical, mental, you know, technical. So it was just a question of whether he'll be able to deliver, you know, whether he himself believed that it is possible.
The confidence which I had, the attitude which I had, was more of let's see how far I can go.
We started believing ourselves, and our band became much more stronger. So we started thinking more about how to get into the top 10.
It was a challenge for me the last few years, say 99-2000. I wasn't getting any younger. At a time when people would say 25 is the peak for a badminton player, I was turning 27, 28, and that was the time when I was starting to get the results. My injuries were also a big challenge for me. My previous matches were a challenge because everything was a new ground. I think to beat somebody like Peter Gade was a new ground. To start going and reaching semis and finals of the biggest events was a new thing.
Now if I think of the way he played that All England, it was just so picture perfect. And the form that he was in, the confidence that he had, the strokes, his stroke selection, his fitness, it was just mind-blowing.
Say for example, that match against Peter Gade, I knew that Peter would try and push the pace, make the rallies faster. So it was kind of important for me to stay on with the pace of the game. And here I was thinking, okay, let me surprise him now. I will rally more. I will keep hanging on with the pace. And I will tell him that after the rally, I am not tired. And then let's see how he reacts. So what I would do is, once the rally starts off and the fast pushes start, I would consistently play that big rally, but post that match, post that rally, go back and be ready for the stands the next time around, so that he is the one who is wanting to take time and slow down. And in his mind he is saying, okay, my god, normally he should be tired, how come he isn't? And he would be surprised. That is what my game plan was.
Peter Gade has one, he is strong in every department, but he had one particular, I would not say weakness, but a very funny part of his game. If you suddenly push him the shuttle high on his overhead area, this area, close to the net, because the shuttle comes so easily to you, he was always nonplussed, he did not know what to do. Now, normally one would say, okay, any shuttle high here or here, you would go back a step and you would jump. You would jump or smash, or without jumping also, he was a tall player, Danish player, he would just smash in and point is over.
To beat Peter Gade, I am sure, in the semi-finals, would have given him a lot of confidence.
Peter Gade was a, I think, was a higher ranked player in that tournament. So the kind of game that Gopi played was remarkable. I mean, I could see a transformed Gopi in that particular match.
A knee injury in the 1994 Pune National Games crippled him and his promising career. It looked like it was all over, with no hope whatsoever on the horizon. Then, the man who stepped in and turned things around completely was Dr. Ashok Rajgopal, who is a popular surgeon in Delhi. Dr. Rajgopal created a magic with all his surgical skills to repair the broken knee.
See, National Games in Pune, it was a tournament for me which was important. I came back from the nationals major ranking in Chennai. I was the winner there. I was so happy to be in that position. I had everything going my way. I was playing fantastic. I beat Dipankar very easily. Quite surprising for many, but for me, I just stamped my authority as being really number one in the country. I was looking forward to the final, and then I had the semi-final where this injury happened. The first immediate reaction was when I fell down, we were up in the game, we were leading in the game, and I said I need to get up and play again because I wanted to win that game. And I was taken out on a stretcher. I still had a feeling that I might come back in the evening and play again in the singles final. It never occurred to me, nor did somebody tell me the entire gravity of the injury.
He had a terrible fall, and you know, and he broke his knee, and the ACL was torn, completely torn. And he was in tears, and we all, you know, being friends and, you know, in a group, we were all shattered.
Radio lo news vintunnamu. Vintunte national games gurinchi cheptoo unnaru. Aa time lo news vintunte Gopi injury ayindi, game ayipoyindi ani cheptunnaru. Em injury ante mem enta pedda injury ayindi kaabalu anukunnam ante kaani dani anta serious ga ankoledu. తర్వాత కొంచెం సేపు అయిన తర్వాత 1 or 2 hours తర్వాత అసావరి అనే ప్లేయర్ కాల్ చేసి చెప్పింది, ఆంటీ గోపి పడ్డాడు, కొంచెం ఇంజురీ అయింది, మేము తీసుకొని ఢిల్లీ వస్తున్నాము అనేసి.
వెన్ వీ స్పోక్ టు హిమ్ యు నో ఓవర్ ఫోన్ హీ సేస్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ ఆల్ రైట్, నథింగ్ హ్యాపన్ టు మీ, ఇట్స్ ఎ స్మాల్ ఇంజురీ లైక్ దట్. అండ్ వీ ఆల్సో ఫెల్ట్ దట్ యు నో ప్లేయర్స్ విల్ హ్యావ్ దీస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. వీ హ్యావ్ నోటీస్డ్ ఎర్లియర్ ఆల్సో సమ్ ఆఫ్ ది బాయ్స్ హ్యావింగ్ దోస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్.
Actually, he was not there when he fell down during that match. I was not there, but as soon as I heard that he's fallen, I went to his room. He was thoroughly prepared for that tournament, and he knew he's going to beat Dipankar. He was playing beautifully, and plus he knew that year he could have done something on the world level as well, and this was a major setback to his career. Actually,
so when he fell down, there were so many critics also, like I should say, no, he can never come back. There were so many people who said his life is over now, his badminton career is over. But I think that made him more stronger.
I'm sure everybody must have written him off the way he had fallen, and it was a whole grafting of the knees. His parents were in Delhi at that time, so I offered to take him along with me.
Train vachindi, andaru dibtunnaru, Gopi dikkaledu, క్రచెస్ అవి అక్కడ పెట్టుకొని స్టేషన్ ఫ్లాట్ సీట్లో అందరు కూర్చున్నారు. ఇదేంటి, ఎవరిగో పాపం ఏ పిల్లలు, అందరు పిల్లలే ఉన్నారే, ఎవరిగో అని నేను ఎవరి కోసమో అనుకుంటున్నాను, కానీ పాపం అని గోపి అని నాకు తెలియలేదు. అండ్ గోపి అవి పట్టుకొని లేవంగానే నేను ఐ వాజ్ షాక్డ్, అండ్ నేను పెద్దగా వచ్చి గొడవ చేశాను. పిల్లలందరూ వచ్చి పట్టుకొని, ఆంటీ ఏం కాలేదు, మనం కిందకి చిన్నగా మోసుకొని వెళ్దాము గోపిని అనేసి, గోపి వాళ్ళ డాడీ ఇంకో ఫ్రెండ్ అందరం కలిపి కిందకి తీసుకొచ్చి అప్పటికి నీ మోకాలు బాగా వాచ్ ఉందండి, స్వెల్లింగ్ ఎక్కువ ఉండింది. అండ్ అప్పటిదాకా మాకు గోపిచిన్నాడు ఆ ఇంజురీస్ అనే పార్ట్ అసలు తెలియదు. అప్పటిదాకా గేమ్ గురించి తెలుసు కానీ ఇంజురీస్ అనే పార్ట్ అంతవరకు తెలియదు మాకు.
సో ఇట్ కేమ్ అస్ అ షాక్ అండ్ ది నేషనల్ గేమ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ వాట్ వాజ్ అ రియలీ హై పాయింట్ టర్న్డ్ అవుట్ ది నెక్స్ట్ ఫ్యూ డేస్ అండ్ మంత్స్ ఇన్ దట్ ఇన్ మై కెరియర్ were kind of one of the lowest points which I had.
For a player who knows nothing apart from badminton, whose life revolves around badminton, for him to get injured and to get injured in such a way where you are not sure that you will ever recover from that kind of an injury is something which actually kills the person inside you.
He came to my house and he with a torn knee and he said, what do I do now? So I said, fine, you know, I just underwent a surgery and I know a very good doctor, Dr. Rajgopal, and I'll take you there.
Ellin tarvata Rajgopal garu chinna operation amma kucho ayirnu kucho nundu anesi naaku cheppesi theater lok teeskellaru. 1 hour 1 and a half hour 2 hours tarvata eppudo bayitku vachi amma adi anukokunda major ayipoyindi pedda injury adi. మరి నేను నువ్వు నమ్మి నాకు కాల్లో చేయటానికి ఆ పర్మిషన్ ఇచ్చేస్తే ఉన్న నీకన్నా మంచి నీ కన్స్ట్రక్ట్ చేస్తాను, నమ్మి ఇచ్చేయమ్మా అన్నారు. ఇంకా మాకు అక్కడ ఆప్షను ఏం లేదు, సరే సార్ మీ ఇష్టం, మీరు ఎట్లా అంటే అట్లా అన్నా.
గోపి కేమ్ టు మై అవుట్ పేషెంట్. టు బి ఆనెస్ట్ ఐ డెంట్ నో అలాట్ అబౌట్ హిమ్. ఫర్ మీ హీ వాజ్ లైక్ ఎనీ అదర్ స్పోర్ట్స్ పర్సన్, బట్ హీ హడ్ కమ్ ఆఫ్ ది వర్చువల్లీ ఆఫ్ ది బ్యాడ్మింటన్ కోర్ట్ హ్యావింగ్ ఇంజర్డ్ హిస్ నీ in one of the nationals. He had a pretty serious knee injury. He had torn his ligaments, his anterior cruciate ligament, which is a pivotal ligament for any sports person, particularly for somebody who plays racket sports like badminton. And more than anything else, the first figurative feeling that I got looking at his face was one of intense disappointment. In a line I could say a lot of hopes which were shattered. He was obviously expecting to do well. He was at a fairly advanced level in the competition, was hoping to get to the top, and this injury sort of shut out his chances. We got talking, we examined him, got the investigations done, and much to our horror and disappointment, we recognized that he had a very major knee injury.
That kind of a thing nobody told me, and I wasn't even in my deepest thoughts thinking that something like this can ever happen.
We did a reconstructive surgery. We recreated his anterior cruciate ligament, which was a pretty major surgical undertaking at that point in time. The immediate concern for us was to be able to get him into a right state of mind mentally.
Not only was he a doctor, but he also was at a time when there were no psychologists, he was the psychologist for me. He was a father figure, he was somebody who really supported me through and through.
Somehow inside of me, I was reasonably confident. I can't say I was absolutely dead sure, but I believed that we could get him back on court. At that point of time, also the challenge was that the rehab protocols were not as well defined as they were today. So we had to sort of, in a way, cut a path through the jungle for him, all by himself. So we worked on that. We worked on his rehab, and at every point of time, I sort of tried to stress to him that he should keep his focus on not only getting well, getting back on the court, but to scale new heights which no Indian badminton player had done.
He would tell me, you do every hour. And there were times where I had alarm the entire night. I would do my exercise, put an alarm, do the exercise again. If it was icing and he said 2 hours, I would go to bed at 8 o'clock, then get up at 10 in the night,
I set again at, I would keep my alarm for 12, then 2 and 4 and 6. So it was kind of, whatever he said, I very religiously followed it. So the progress was good.
In the course of one of his conversations with me, he says, how good do you think I'm going to get? And I said, it's a question of what you believe you're capable of doing. And I said, from my perspective, I think you should be the All England badminton champion. I mean, for me, that's the scale that you've, that's the peak you have to scale. I think somehow that word got into his head or into his psyche. He never spoke about that again, and neither did I. So he went through his recovery, he was doing well. He was a very good student of the rehab process.
Sometimes I would try and explain and he would not understand it, so he would come physically to watch and just tell me what is it and then what kind of exercises you need to do. More than what he told, the fact that he was there solidly behind me.
Here was a story where I was in a way very intricately involved with every emotion of this individual, you know, from despair to pain to sorrow to frustration to hope to ultimately getting to a point where he actually won. So it was an amazing journey. I don't think I've done that with any other athlete. You know, we've operated on so many of them.
There were so many people who said his life is over now, his badminton career is over. But I think that made him more stronger.
For me, it was good when somebody said, "Ye langda kabhi nahi khel sakta hai." I just took that as a challenge.
యాక్చువల్గా ఆపరేషన్ అంత అయిన తర్వాత ఫీజు ఎంతో అడిగేసి రండి అనేసి మేము ఈయన నేను కూర్చొని ఈయన్ని పంపించాను. యాక్చువల్గా మీరు అడగండి ఫీజు ఎంత అంటే నాకు అసలు ఏమీ వద్దు, నా ఫీజు మాత్రం ఆల్ ఇంగ్లాండ్ ఛాంపియన్షిప్ గెలవటమేను నా ఫీజు అని చెప్పారు.
వెన్ ద ఆల్ ఇంగ్లాండ్ స్టార్టెడ్ మై బిఫోర్ లీవింగ్ హీ స్పోక్ టు మీ అండ్ హీ సెడ్ యు నో డాక్ విష్ మీ వెల్ అండ్ ఐ సెడ్ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ విషింగ్ యూ వెల్ యూ గాట్ టు కమ్ బ్యాక్ విత్ ద ఛాంపియన్షిప్ దట్ ఇస్ ది ఓన్లీ థింగ్ దట్స్ గోయింగ్ టు సాటిస్ఫై మీ.
Those were the words which he said, and luckily for me, I was able to repay him about 8 years later.
Gopi evolved his unique winning strategies because of his ability to analyze and predict the strengths, weaknesses and the game plans of his opponents. His craftsmanship can be specifically seen in the All England Championship in 2001.
The moment he defeated Peter Gerd, I had in my mind definitely title was ours. I had no fear at all about Chan Hong. For me, Chan Hong was not that much experienced compared to Peter Gerd.
Yeah, Peter Gerd semi-finals was huge. I think I hadn't beaten him before. I was fully prepared. He is a very strong opponent.
Well, honestly speaking, when he was pitted to play Peter Gerd, not many believed that he would win because Peter Gerd was playing excellent badminton. But as the match started, one could see that Gopi was matching Peter Gerd stroke for stroke. This was, I think, a very good thing. Part of his strategy was not to let Peter Gerd score any easy points.
The big challenge came from Peter Gerd in the semi-finals. The Dane had Gopi stretching every sinew to subdue the former. In two extended games, Gopi came up trumps, 17-15, 17-15.
It was not only the challenge of playing the semi-finals, but I remember practicing and saying, putting three people across on the court or sometimes four people across and say, Peter Gerd plays like this, so I want this stroke of this quality against me.
Well, I think the match against Peter Gerd was very interesting because a couple of services that he did, you know, when the match was really close at, I think, 13 all or, you know, 13-14, and he just hit a couple of flick services, which was something, again, as I mentioned, Gopi coming up with something innovative.
If you look at the match, actually, I was leading by big margins in both the matches, both the games, and he caught up, and there were not many easy points from my side, but there were
lines which missed by so much, about 3 to 4 times in both the matches, both the games. And had I wrapped that up, probably the score line would have looked 15-8, 15-6 or something, or 15-10, and I would have done up with that match. But what was interesting is he came back strongly. The momentum was on his side. And it, I had to really go deep and think of things which I hadn't done. And luckily there were a few strokes with me which I hadn't used in the match. And I surprised him with a crucial half smash overhead on the deuce, on the points of deuce. And also a cross net which I played, which was very good. And couple of serves which I did, which surprised him. So these were all things I think I was smarter. And I was more alert during that time. But I think it was a great match against a great opponent. And it is a match which for me was the final.
I think he had prepared very well. And I think that was, you know, the very fact that he didn't lose a single game against players, you know, of Peter Gade and Chen Long. I think, you know, so that itself showed that he was in top form.
With the last leg of the journey left, Gopichand cruised to the glory with a comfortable 15-12, 15-6 victory over China's Chen Hong.
The finals, I remember going back after the Petergate match and I was tired. Physically, it was my body started feeling the pressure of the concrete surface. My body started to ache quite a bit. I iced and iced and iced. And I was struggling to recover. The one good thing which I realized was there was a horrendous match between two of my opponents of the other semi-finals, Roslyn Hashim and Chen Hong. And I knew that that match would have taken the toll off whoever the winner was. So I came back to the room and I met Hashim on the way back for dinner, and he said, "Gopi, it was a long match and Chen Hong was also tired." I was happy to hear that.
When Gopi went to play the Chinese Chen Long, it was a match that one will never forget. Beating a Chinese and that too in the finals is something that is really incredible. Gopi planned his match, played his match to clockwork precision.
Chen Hong's match went on expected lines in the sense we fought hard after the first game in the initial part of the second game at 6-all, and I knew that I had to stick on and keep pace with him, and I got the breakthrough, and it was a match I think I was able to wrap up quite neatly in the end.
Chen Hong didn't know where the shuttle went. It was incredible to see him. He just didn't know. He was so baffled. His dribbles were excellent. Chen Hong would dribble and he would re-dribble again. And Chen Hong would wonder what to do. He would lift the shuttle and Gopi would whack it down, you know. So it was incredible.
Chen Hong is a player who used to thrive on playing an attacking game. And when you are slightly slow, you are not able to get under the shuttle, you know. And if you can't do that, then you are left to retrieve. And Gopi also played very intelligently, kept him attacking all the time, and with some fine net dribbles created the openings that were very vital.
He just played a brilliant match in the final with all that pressure.
He had the ability, we had the confidence that he could do it.
The way he dominated the Chinese was actually great.
Gopi was absolutely focused. I was more excited than Gopi.
Pullela Gopichand's life is a saga of self-belief and struggle, and is backed by sacrifices, not only by him, but also by his parents. In fact, right from his childhood, winning is all that Gopi has thought about.
The first time I picked the racket, I think it must have been in Madras, where we had a huge ground outside with a little badminton court, not the full size, but half of it. We used to play because my aunt was a player, Manjala. From when I remember, and the sense when we were in Ongole, when we were in Madras, I think every time it was that I would just put my school bag down and I would just run out. And I always remember my mom trying to run behind me to feed me as a young kid. And I would play, and mom would come, try to fetch me to get some food or come for a wash kind of a thing. So sport was very dear to me in the sense, given a chance, I would go play. And what I used to play is, would be things like marbles, would be chain cut, which would be chor police, whatever is that game which was being played, I used to play that.
Actually, Gopi chala active undevadu, chala pillalato aadevadu, cricket aadatam chala ishtapadevadu. And roju Gopi amma ani nen Madras lo undagane kinda nunchi kekalesadu edo chesesadu anesi, ee kitkil pagalgottunado edo okati vachestunnayi complaints anesi వస్తూనే ఉండేవి కంప్లైంట్స్. ఇక్కడికి వచ్చిన తర్వాత ఇక బ్యాడ్మింటన్ చూసిన తర్వాత ఇంకా అంతకన్నా టైం దొరకలేదు. వాడు చాలా ఇష్టపడటం మొదలెట్టాడు. మార్నింగ్ యాక్చువల్గా 4:35కి వాళ్ళ డాడీ తీసుకెళ్లేవాళ్ళు, నడుచుకుంటూ వెళ్ళేవాళ్ళు, చేసుకొని వచ్చేవాడు. అండ్ వాడు చాలా ఇష్టపడుతున్నాడని మేము డిసైడ్ అయిన తర్వాత ఇంకా అసలు వెనక్కి తిరిగి చూద్దామని కానీ ఏమీ ఆలోచించలేదు మేము.
పేరెంట్స్ టుక్ మీ టు the Lal Bahadur Stadium. They were the ones who were looking around to see which sport we would take. Tennis looked a little expensive, a lot more people with many cars there, so they decided that let's look at badminton because he's played, we've got some connect to the sport because my aunt had played earlier, and that's how I just went and joined the sport. It wasn't really that the decision was made as though this was a career or not. It was like, okay, he's playing so much time anyway, let us put him in something because he looks inclined to play and he doesn't study so well, so let us put him into sport. It was more of a decision like that, I would say.
Badminton start chesindi Hamid Hussain gar degare LB stadium lo. Vaalla father elli kuchunde vaallu kani Hamid Hussain cheptu unde vaallu vide edo chesestadu anesi Hamid Hussain sir antu unde vaallu.
For people who know Hamid sir, sir was somebody like a father figure, and when he was there around on court, we would all be shivering on court, and that kind of discipline was very important.
Hamid bhai has almost like given all the things in my hand as you want to do it, because at that particular time I was also coaching the Indian team. I was coaching the Indian team since 1974. I came in 1979. The Gopi had come when he was almost 11 year old, at the, I would say, around 85 end or something, he had come down here. He was hardly about 10 plus or something like that. Then what happened was, this boy I found, when everybody wanted to stop, he wanted to continue. Then he'll come and say, sir, shall I do a little more? For instance, we have got, say, around about 10 sprints. He'll say, shall I do about 5 sprints more, sir? We have got on some training on the court or off the court or something. He'll simply come and say, sir, shall I do a little more of that? So that was something very positive. And usually I found the champion stuff is like that. When everybody wants to stop, the champion wants to continue. This is something which is very important. And people say champions are born. I say no, it's an attitude.
I love to play, and I was somebody who had a lot of energy growing up. I would spend a lot of time on court. I would just be waiting. I was smart. So whenever there was even a 1 minute on court which I could get, I would just jump in and play. Or I would try and play with the younger kids, try and play with the senior kids. And that's the kind I was on court.
The determination to achieve great heights propelled him forward to state and national level competitions. Gopi also briefly shared the ranking journeys with his brother, Rajashekhar.
We had our share of practice matches and fights over line calls and things like that. So on the court, we've always given everything we can. The one in exhibition rounds, which was a very good fight between the two of us, and the one in the state championship, I think Gopi was also playing the under 14, so So we played one game which I barely managed to win, and then he let it go because he wanted to play, he wanted to save energy for the next game.
I know Gopi since 86 when I was just 11 year old, and we were together almost for all the tournaments like state, Andhra Pradesh. So we used to play the state tournaments, nationals and all these national camps together. So I know him very well since beginning, and the thing is the hardships he underwent are very much like, but then he took into his stride and he overcame all that.
Whenever he's training, he wants to first of all give his best, and the second thing was everybody has stopped at one particular point, he wants to continue. That was his plus point.
I still remember in the camps, like we used to have our sessions morning, forenoon and evening. And Gopi, I should say, once our session used to finish, we used to go to the room and take rest or whatever. But this guy used to stay back, do another half an hour or 1 hour extra exercises which coaches had, you know, given him. So that all, you know, paid him off.
Gopi was the first player from our country who has developed that speed and power game. Gopi wanted to go for the attack, move, attack, faster, jump, all those things. So I had to develop his game depending on his abilities and his attitude towards the game. So I found that when he was doing that, he was able to get the success.
He has come out of RF stable was a big plus point, because most of the people who come out of that stable are technically very sound.
Arif sir, I think he's been great. Today, in terms of discipline, in terms of what a coach should be, I think a lot of credit for that definitely has to go to Arif sir.
As time went on and Gopi started showing progress, he graduated and went over to the Prakash Padukone Academy. That transformed his game from a player into a champion at the international level.
He had the mind of a champion. He could study and grasp whatever was said very quickly, and not only grasp but also improve upon it depending on the situation. So I think that was a big plus point in Gopi's career.
Prakash sir was different in the sense I was very aggressive from innate, from my nature, from the style which I have practiced in Hyderabad. And also when I started to train under Shawmin, my game was in a particular mode. It was only attack. And if the attack didn't work, then I had no fallback option. And that is what Prakash sir, I think, realized and put into my game. He would say that, okay, there is okay, this is fine, but you also have to rally, you also have to be defensive sometimes, and that is also important. So he made me play the long rallies. I had the speed but I didn't have the endurance so much or the patience so much. So he worked in regards to my patience, in regards to my just putting the shuttle back on court and following the opponent. That is also something which he would say. And then those things definitely added to my game, and when required, I had a fallback option which I didn't have for many years in my career.
He was always learning from people. It was never that, you know, though he was dominant, though he was already winning, he still wanted to learn from the others. So he would constantly be watching, you know, trying to pick up different strokes, different nuances, different, you know, ways of serve, different strategies. So it's always this learning, you know, that, you know, helped him through his career.
Shawmin, a Chinese coach had come. He has selected 10 players. But when he has selected 10 players, out of around 30 and odd players at that particular camp, Gopi was not there. After a few days' time, the Malaysians have sent their junior team to India. And at that particular time, we thought, we'll make our senior players also play because they are coming, juniors are coming and beating all the tournaments here in our country. That will be giving a bad name in badminton. So what we thought is, we'll keep one or two juniors whenever they are playing in that particular place so that they are getting an exposure. But ultimately our team is winning in the test match. But when they came to Hyderabad, Mr. Puri said, oh bhai, your top players are here. At that time my only players, Manoj Kumar, Praveen Kumar were there. So let them play. Gopi will not. I said, no sir. Gopi is the top player for our country now. We have got to make him play. Ultimately, they have agreed, okay. Gopi had won against the junior from Malaysia. At that particular time, Shaman was standing over there because he was there already in our country. He said, Gopi, I said, he was there in the camp, you are not selected. Immediately the next camp what we had, the first person whom Shaman was called was, I want Gopi, 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 Gopi. I said, okay.
For me, the camp in Patiala gave me a chance to actually play all the players, all the top players over a period of time. I would train with them, I would stay with them, and I was playing them. And the first day I was losing easily, but in the second, third day things started becoming better. I started knowing what kind of strategy to play against which player, and that really helped. Pretty much we were doing a lot of training which was picked up from athletics, but nothing really specific to what badminton requirements were. And for the first time Wong Shaoman came on and he put us through a set of exercises which were for badminton. All of us were dead tired. We had no clue what was happening with our bodies, in the sense we were really very tired, and also every muscle in our body was, we started to feel that, oh, is there a muscle here as well? So that's the kind of feeling we started to have, and very different from what we had ever done before. So Wong Shaoman for Indian badminton was a great help.
The Chinese coach actually brought in a lot of changes into our system, into our thought process about how to approach badminton training. And Gopi, I think, actually benefited from that of the Chinese coach's presence in India.
In the years to come, he would take on the badminton biggies such as Rajiv Bagga and Dipankar Bhattacharya, losing to them initially but beating them eventually in the bigger events.
I kept experimenting to see what was the right level of aggression, what was the right level of defensive play, and it just took so many more years to kind of get to that stage.
Gopi was always very aggressive. He was hungry to, you know, score points early as possible to make, you know, and he always used to find out you know, the weakness of a player, how to tackle this player, like as you said, Abhinshan Gupta or Dipankar. That time Dipankar was at his peak. Dipankar was the national champion and he was been beating Gopi in the finals or quarter finals or semi finals. Gopi lost to him. I remember then it was difficult to, you know, go through Dipankar Bhattacharya. So I remember in the Pune Nationals where Manjusha also won the title there, both of them won the senior title. So Gopi is like, that was his first title, and I remember the way he, you know, in the same court where he fell during the national games. And on the same court, he won his nationals, first national title. So that time I remember that, you know, his game plan was so good that he didn't allow Dipankar to do anything. And after that, he never looked back.
Yes, Rajiv and I were at that point of time the rivals, the fiercest rivals at that point of time. And then with Gopi's entry, it became a threesome affair at the top. So yes, Gopi did pose a lot of challenges to us, and we shared a lot of rivalry at that point of time.
Gopi is, was quite sharp with his mind. He had developed very good net play, also the half smashes, and he could read the opponent. That is very, very important. You know, if you want to become a good player, you should be able to read your opponent's game, in which I feel that he was much sharper as compared to the other players, Indian players during that time.
He had a good net game, and he effectively used many strokes in the same action. We call it double action tosses, and he has used it, his half smashes, as an opening creators. That was also his, I mean, especially over it, cross half smash. They perhaps may not be the winners, but they were opening creators where he could catch them on the net and then toss it.
I think it was the most toughest periods in which Gopi emerged as a player and set a trend that yes, Indians, you know, can do it in their own way of training. So I think that is what made him stand out.
Post the injury in 94, 96, 98, almost although I was consistently winning at the national level
there was certain elements in my game which I wasn't really happy about. I wanted to do a few things. I wanted a little more freedom in training. I wanted to do a lot more things, whether it regards to physical training or mental aspects. I started looking at them more deeply, very, very new things I wanted to try out. And then I made the switch around 99, where I moved from the Prakash Academy in Bangalore itself to the Sai Center in Kengeri, Bangalore, where I had my coach as Ganguly Prasad.
He came to me, was already, I think, operated 2-3 times, and it was always in my mind, because, you know, to get results, I cannot overtrain him and get him injured again. So these are all the things, you know, were very much in my mind. So having our limitations, you know, we need to work to get him to the best in shape.
The training was tough. The training was very physical, as I said. But also the fact remained that I spent a lot of time more thinking about the game, visualizing, analyzing.
And we have really planned well. And slowly, each and every segment we used to work and remove his weaknesses. And in fact, you know, we used to, you know, work more on his smash, dribbles and all these things. So definitely over a period of time, it really helped him. And the result is that next Malaysian Open, he reached semi-finals. And he almost defeated Taufik Hidayat there. So that gave both of us a very good boost in our confidence.
The Hamid Hussain Memorial Tournament remained the driving force for Gopi. This tournament was named after the man who taught him the rudiments of the game. The prestigious Sydney Olympics in 2000, after his recovery, was a disaster in his illustrious career. But failures always reaffirmed his determination to improve his skills and approach his goals.
The Olympics, I think that was very critical in the sense, although I lost the Olympics, the Olympics, the way I prepared for the Olympics probably led to the victory at the All England in a way. Although there were a 6 months gap in between both these events, I prepared for the best possible shape for the Olympics, and then post that Olympic loss, I was really disheartened. Well, it was strange for me at the Olympics, because I had no clue of why after a certain match, which was I played the first round against Ladislav Drushenko of Ukraine, we played a 3-set match. It was a tough game, very physical. I won on my fitness. I prolonged the rallies long enough to crack him. But strangely, when I went back to my room and got up in the, had an afternoon nap and got up later, my body was very, very sore. And by the next morning when I got up, I was running temperature. And when I went on court, I was really very, very tired because of the soreness and also of the temperature. So I just lost to Hendravan, whom I beat later in my career and whom I thought I should have won there on a normal day.
He lost to Hendravan at the Olympics, the Indonesian, and I think he was devastated, I think, after that loss, because he really, really believed within himself that he had a chance to get a medal. Physically he was fine, mentally he was fine, it was just tactically he should have been a little more prepared to play his opponent, because his opponent came out knowing what Gopi is going to do from point one, if you watch that match. So I think maybe if Gopi was more prepared, he could have even won that match.
Almost not even immediately after the Olympics, I knew what happened. After the match, after a couple of days, then I was speaking to other players, then I realized that the surface what we played on was on concrete. We normally in our entire careers have had tournaments which were basically held on sprung wooden flooring. We came back from there, started to run on the road a little bit so that my foot get used to pounding on hard surfaces. And luckily for me, that helped at the All England.
Every major award was a feather in his cap.
First award was the Arjuna. It was in 99. It was a fantastic award, I think, as a player. I think that is what motivates a lot of us. And for normal, lot of people, I think the Arjuna Award is the first step of being recognized at the national level for sport. Having won the Arjuna, or having been awarded the Arjuna, I think the rest of the awards, if I were to look at little deeply, I won the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna post the win at the All England. I wasn't really expecting it, or it wasn't on my radar, I would say. But I was happy that I won the Khel Ratna, it being the highest sporting award in the country. I think it was something which is which I very dearly cherish. And then in 2004 was the Padma Shri Award. It was special because almost my career as a player was finished, and I was getting into the next phase, and it came at a time when probably I needed that inspiration. 2009 was the Dronacharya. I think as a coach, that's the highest recognition we have in our country. Very happy to receive that. I think it was important. I think important because there was this common concept or misconcept that good players cannot be good coaches. And to break that, I think the Dronacharya really paved a way in a way. 2014, Padma Bhushan, huge award. The Academy had the award, the Rashtriya Khel Protsahan Puraskar in 2013. That was a huge award, I think. It was not really an award for me per se, but it's for my entire team at the Academy. I think the Rashtriya Khel Protsahan Puraskar was very important. Very glad and happy that my parents went and took the award. Each award at that point of time was very, very important, and all of them served as huge motivations to me and to my entire team and family and group.
Post playing career, Gopi took to coaching like a fish to water. What made his tutoring outstanding was that he always led by example from his exceptionally illustrious badminton career. The discipline imbibed from SMRF, wisdom from Prakash Padukone, mentoring of Ganguly Prasad and Leroy Desir, along with his playing skills, has laid the foundation for his idea of coaching.
First outstanding player to get into coaching as far as India is concerned was Prakash Padukone, which was somewhere in the early 90s or late 80s. And after that, it is Gopichand who has got into full-time coaching. And being a player who has played at the highest level, being a player who has the analytical ability, I think he is an ideal person to be a coach.
You know, all the right qualities, you know, dedication, discipline, talent, you know, self-belief, all the qualities, you know, means his, whatever, as a player, you know, then he's taken it to the next level, you know, as a coach.
Well, it's been a great transformation for me. Each year, each day has been a great learning for me. For me as a coach, when I started off, it started off as a journey which came by basically to give back something. I had some young kids who came up to me for advice. That's how the whole coaching aspect started.
Something which is like a very good happened to Indian badminton. The kind of change he has come, you know, in Indian badminton is only because of Gopi.
It's not so difficult in my opinion to be a good coach, but I think common sense is very important. Hard work is very important, and if you have the desire, you will find a way of making things happen.
He gets up in the morning at 4 o'clock. I used to stay there in the camps for Commonwealth Games I was there for 2 years almost. So I used to see this guy is coming to the academy at 6 o'clock in the morning, playing with the kids, staying there, eating there, you know, then again going back and again coming back, and house was almost 5-6 kilometers from there. His whole thing was academy. And only dream is that player should play well.
I think it's a very it's a very vibrant, it's a very challenging role which we are in, and I think as much as people would say it's tough and it's pressure, I believe that that is what the beauty of it is. In the sense, you have on the other side, I and Zia Zwanze have played the finals of the German Open. And today when I sit for say a Saina's match or a Sindhu's match or a Kashyap's match or a Guru or a Srikant's match, I have him sitting opposite side. I have, say, Chen Jin sitting on the women's coaching staff, and we have played together. So it's kind of a very very good scenario. It's a very challenging scenario, and you as players are competing, we as coaches are still competing. I say, you do this and I'm going to produce somebody who is better than you. So it's kind of a very, very nice equation to have, and very happy to be part of this kind of energy basically.
His wife Lakshmi and me were playing together doubles, and three of us used to be together. His first priority was badminton. Now also it's badminton. As a coach, I can see, you know, family is second, then even coaching aspect, badminton is first priority. That's why even as a coach, he's producing good results. You can see that.
There was no stroke he could not demonstrate, drawing from his rich repertoire and edifying experience. As the chief coach for the Indian badminton team, Pullela has made considerable contribution in shaping the upcoming shuttlers.
I think Gopi is doing a tremendous job as a coach. He has been a very practical, self-made player. He knows the difficulties that the players have gone through and the players will go through. He knows what is the current requirement at the international level. And the most important part is that he is willing to give back to the game what he got from the game. That is again another great quality.
Gopi at present is doing a wonderful job for the country. We'll continue with the passion for the coaching and will start bringing many more lols for the country also. Without the passion, the coaching will not be there.
Whatever transformation we are seeing today in Indian badminton, Saina doing so well, Sindhu doing so well, Kashyap, a whole bunch of players, youngsters coming up and doing so well at the international level. People are talking, Chinese are talking about Indian badminton, Indonesians who never used to bother about us are talking about Indian badminton. It is that very decision by Badminton Association of India to choose a player who has played at that level as the chief national coach. I think that is the transformation. That is what has brought the transformation to Indian badminton.
He's a perfect role model, you know, not just as a player, later on as a coach also. He has set very high standard, you know, for himself and for the country, and it is worthy of emulation by other sports people.
He has actually become a legend and an example for every upcoming youngsters who can emulate him.
As the journey unfolds, if you ask me today, I think I'm very happy with what I have. And it's been very fulfilling. My entire life has been very fulfilling.
The Indian tradition credits the best fulfillment of a parent's or teacher's role when his disciple or offspring outshines him. Saina and Nehwal came close to giving shape to that dream. It won't be long before one of his disciples reaches a new glory in the world of badminton. Gopi has been producing the assembly line of champions with his coaching. His strokes are master strokes in harmony with the universe. They are just like the beautiful musical notes in harmony with the tune of life. Pullela Gopichand is indeed a legend.
Thank you.
of India.